man, but wants of poverty are for to man change. Good morning to one another. Today, October 17th, World Poverty Eradication Day. The International Day for the Eradication of Poverty is observed every year on October 17th across the world. It is the day to mark worldwide poverty, hunger, violence, fear, and various methods to mitigate it. Every year, the United Nations observes this day with a theme. The theme of this year is Building Forward Together, Ending Persistent Poverty, Respecting All People and Our Planet. On this day, Commerce Club presents a video relating to the concept of poverty and the various methods to eradicate poverty with special reference to India.
Poverty is the inability to secure the minimum consumption requirements of life, health and efficiency. There are poor both in urban and rural areas. Urban poor includes people who live in slums, street vendors, domestic maids, rag pickers, unorganized workers, particularly women, beggars, etc. They live in kaccha houses of mud walls and thatched roofs. Rural poor includes landless agricultural laborers who get to work only for a few days, unemployed, members of SC and ST segments, unhealthy people who doesn't have any job, etc.
Poverty line is the cutoff point which divides population as poor and non-poor. The cutoff point can be on a line of distribution of income. People whose incomes are below the poverty line are poor, and those whose incomes are above the poverty line are non-poor. Before independence, Dadabhai Nauroji estimated a poverty in India using poverty line. He used the items given to a prisoner and the prevailing prices of these items to calculate a jail cost of living. The official poverty line is the expenditure incurred to obtain the goods in a poverty line basket, PLB. Poverty line basket includes food, clothing, rent, conveyance, and entertainment. In India, poverty is measured by committees appointed by the central government. Tendulkar Committee, Rangarajan Committee, etc. are the important committees appointed by the government.
In India, poverty is categorized as always poor, usually poor, crowning poor, and occasionally poor. People, those who are permanently in poverty, are under always poor. Usually poor are those who have a little money that temporarily lift them out of poverty. Those who move in and out of poverty are categorized as crowning poor. Usually not poor but fall into poverty now and then are comes under occasionally poor.
The number of poor is estimated as the proportion of people below the poverty line. It is known as headcount ratio. It is estimated on the basis of consumption expenditure data collected by the National Sample Survey Organization. According to the report, in India, 22% of population are under the poverty line. Majority of the poor in India are in Orissa, Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh. These states account for 50% of India's poor. Poverty is low in states like Goa, Kerala, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, and Andhra Pradesh.
Low income, lack of assets, unemployment, inequalities, isolation and powerlessness, exploitation, low economic growth, backward agriculture, and low land of industrialization and inflation are the main causes of poverty. Apart from this, the colonial exploitation by the British and the zamindar system, unequal caste system, joint family system, etc., led to the poverty in India.
There are so many methods to eradicate poverty. 15 countries here made a rapid progress in reducing extreme poverty. Tanzania almost halved its extreme poverty in just over a decade. China, Moldova, and Vietnam effectively ended its extreme poverty by 2015. In India, still 22% of population are below the poverty line. Now we can analyze the various methods adopted by government, non-government, and other organizations to eradicate poverty. The government introduced growth-oriented approaches, self-employment and wage employment programs, food security programs, and social security programs to eradicate poverty.
Growth-oriented approach is based on the expectation that the effects of the economic growth would rapidly increase GDP and per capita income. This would reach all sections of the society and for the betterment of the poor sections.
Self-employment programs aims to identifying the poor and educated unemployed people and providing them loans to help them engage in self-employment. Self-employment programs are SGSY, Swarna Jayanti Gram Swarozgar Yojana, originally known as IRDP. This program is assisted by the families below the poverty line to find self-employment. Assistance were given to the families and individuals. Second one, SJSRY. Swarna Jayanti Shahari Rozgar Yojana. SJSRY shall seek to provide the gainful employment to the urban unemployed or underemployed poor through encouraging the setting up of self-employment ventures or provision for wage employment. Third one is PMRY, Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Yojana. PMRY is a central government initiative which provides self-employment opportunities to the educated youth who are unemployed. The fourth one is REGP, Rural Employment Generation Program. This program aims to creating the self-employment opportunities to the rural areas and small towns. This is being implemented by the Khadi and Village Industries Commission, KVIC.
Wage employment programs are implemented to provide employment to people on a daily wage basis. People in this category include poor unskilled laborers who do not own any properties. They contribute in creating public assets like bonds, tanks, schools, hospitals, etc.
In 2005, the Indian Parliament passed the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. It guaranteed wage employment to those who are ready to work. Employment is guaranteed for 100 days a year at the minimum wage rate.
In Kerala, this scheme is known as Thozhilurappu Paddhathi. It was implemented in Palakkad and Wayanad districts initially on 5th February 2006, and it was extended to all the 14 districts in the state on 1st April 2008. Kerala is a tiny state in India with very high unemployment. Most of them are educated in the country. Around 5 lakh people among them are estimated to have willingness to do physical labor. The scheme now provides Rs. 291 per person for a stipulated quality of manual labor offered as registered worker in the local government in Kerala. National Food for Work Program and Sampurna Gramin Rozgar Yojana are other important wage employment programs.
Food security entails ensuring adequate food supply to people. especially those who are deprived of basic nutrition. Food security has been a major concern in India. Public distribution system. The Indian food security system was established by the Government of India under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. Food and public distribution to distribute food and non-food items to India's poor at subsidized rates. Food Corporation of India, a government-owned corporation, procures and maintains the public distribution system. Integrated Child Development Scheme. Integrated Child Development Scheme is a government program in India which provides nutritional meals, preschool education, primary health care, immunization, health checkup, and referral services to children under 6 years of age and their mother. Midday meals at schools. Midday meal is a wholesome, freshly cooked lunch served to children in government and government-aided schools in India. This scheme aims to avoid classroom hunger, increase school enrollment, increase school attendance, improve socialization among caste, address malnutrition, and empower women through employment. Annapurna Scheme. Under this scheme, 10 kilograms of food grains is distributed per month free of cost to destitute above the age of 65 years with no or meager subsistence. Antyodaya Anna Yojana. Antyodaya Anna Yojana is the sponsor scheme of Government of India to provide highly subsidized food to millions of the poorest families.
Social security programs are imposed and controlled by the government unit for the purpose of providing social benefits to the member of the community as a whole or a particular section of the community.
Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana gives insurance protection to the workmen employed in informal occupation.
Indira Gandhi National Old Age Pension Scheme gives Rs. 500 to each member aged 65 and above belonging to BPL families. Atal Pension Yojana was intended to provide pension in unorganized sector for the age group 18 to 40. National Social Assistance Program, Janashri Bima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana are the important social security program.
The COVID-19 pandemic has led to a dramatic loss of human life worldwide and present an unprecedented challenge to public health, food systems, and the world of work. It is said that the rural poverty rate increased by 15% and the urban poverty rate was up nearly by 20%. Job losses were higher for states with a higher average COVID caseload. Maharashtra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh and Delhi contributed disproportionately to job loss. Households have coped by reducing food intake, borrowing land, selling assets. Government releases has helped to avoid the most severe form of distress. But the reach of support measures is incomplete, leaving out some of the most vulnerable workers and households. Additional government support is urgently needed now for two reasons: compensating the issues sustained during the first wave and anticipating the impact of the second wave. This can include continuing free rations, additional cash transfers and expanded MNREGA and an urban job program.
Dr. West Stafford said, "The opposite of poverty is not wealth. The opposite of poverty is enough." With this in mind, India's efforts have helped to curb poverty in some extent. The role of government and international cooperation are vital in the fight against poverty. Statistics shows India has reduced its poverty from 50% in 1980 to 22% in 2021, collaborating with the factors like civil society, including community organization and self-help group. The government can lead the way by developing policies and initiation of sustainable action to put an end or reduce significantly the incidence of poverty in the world. On this day, let us pledge to work together to eradicate poverty. Thank you.